What's poppin'? It's your boy King Blake. Now today we're back at it again on Bomber Grounds. I have some advanced warfare tips, if that's what you want to call them, to combat and getting so you can up and get higher K average kills per game, and also in hand up your win rate. Now on average, I have 2.2 kills per game, which is pretty good, and I have roughly 22-23% win rate. So I've been kind of finessing. I don't know if this guy's gonna play. I'm now the party leader, I guess. Oh well, we'll just leave and we'll start up a game. So I have some tips for you guys, and hope you guys will learn something really helpful. But just to start off, thank you to Gigantic Duck. I am now an approved content creator for Bomber Grounds. So what does that mean? I'll be getting content earlier for you guys. So if there's an update coming, I believe I will be getting just an earlier look on that, which is really clutch. I got in right before they upped the amount of subs. So I don't know. Well, we'll take it. We'll take it. So now that we're loading into a game, I guess we'll start off with tip number one I have for you guys. Figure out what type of player you are. Now, what do I mean by that? So if you play Brawl Stars, or if you know Brawl Stars, there's different game modes. Now, it is proven, and this is something I like to say a lot, you're going to just do better in game modes you like playing. So you want to figure out what game mode, like if you really like Brawl Ball, which is what I do, I win a lot more in Brawl Ball. And I tend to lose a lot in Showdown just because I dislike playing in Showdown. Now, there's this guy. Let's just get this easy kill on him real quick. Thank you for the kill, kind stranger. But again, you have to figure out. So there's two main strategies and two sort of play styles that you can play as in Bomber Grounds. And one is being passive. So what I mean by that is these are all early game strategies. So if you're being passive, that usually means you're grinding out stars early game. So you're going to you're going and you're breaking the crates and you're breaking the boxes and you're getting those stars, you're getting the power-ups. And then you grind up levels that way. Now, another strategy you can do and employ is what I like a lot more, is being much more aggressive early game and getting your kills through being aggressive and getting your stars. How did I not die there? Getting your stars through killing others. That's how I like playing the game. That guy's just dead. We're the kill leader now with 3 kills, which is, I guess, decent. Top 3. I really like our position here because we're just bigger than everyone, so we should be able to just walk in and smack both of these people. No! What? Oh my gosh, I threw that game. I should not have lost that. I did not even see. My guy was so big, I covered the bomb, and I could not see the bomb. That's actually really infuriating. Oh well. You know, we'll move on. I don't really care, because we got 4 kills, and that's going to statistically up my kill average, and that's all, honestly all I really care about, getting up my kill average kills per game. So again, if you're being passive, we're just going to go over the general idea of what you want to do. Now, you want to optimize your bomb use. So what do I mean by that? So you want to hit as many crates as possible with your one bomb. So if we look up here, there's these 2 crates. I can use one bomb to break those 2 crates, and then that's going to save me bombs, and that's going to save me ammo to use on enemies if they come at me. So we're just going to live, I think. That guy's trying to time a kill on me. Now, I think I'll be able to get you. No, I missed the swing, unfortunately. So if you're playing passive, again, like right here, using that one bomb to destroy both crates right there. I don't know if this guy's passive or not. Idle or not. Looks like he's finally back. I don't know what that guy's doing. There's a lot of people up here. So what we're going to do is employ our second trick. Using more than one bomb when you're attacking. So in areas like here, you can hit 2 bombs and you can hit a lot. You can hit more people because you're covering more ground. Or you can even go for 3 if you hit all 3, of course. Sometimes it's a little inconsistent, but again, you're covering a lot more area than you would be if you're only shooting one bomb. And you might look there. That's a kill because we were using 3 bombs. He had literally nowhere to go. So if you can use 2 bombs or even 2 or 3, 2 is honestly much better early game, because now I don't know how that didn't hit. But again, so if you're really small, you're not going to be able to hit all 3. So early game, you're going to probably be using 2, but 2 is just fine because that's enough to get you kills and cover a lot more area than you would be if you were just using 1 bomb.
So if that guy's coming over here, I'm kind of scared. I don't think I'll be able to... no, we aren't. I don't know what to do in this situation. Wow, he got that kill. That's a really good play. And that's probably going to give him the win here. Unless we can kind of clutch up and hit him with bombs. But he's got that charged up. That's pretty good for him. We really have to get in an area to where we can hit at him from distance. But we are a little faster than him when he's charging. But he has such a big range with his trident. We're just going to spam bombs now. I don't even know what to do, to be honest. This is like one of those things in the match where it just gets to a stalemate. And we're probably just, yeah, we'll just give him the win. I don't know. That was just going to go on for way too long. He was just, the thing I dislike about this game is when it becomes a one-on-one, it can last for so long because you can just dodge the whole time. And it doesn't, like, you just dodge. So sometimes if I'm in the last player, I honestly don't really care. So I just let him have the win. And because I don't really care, I just don't want to waste that much time. I'd rather just get into a new game. So if you're using one bomb, you're only covering realistically a single cross. But if you're using two bombs, you're covering double the area. So this is really good, especially early game when it's a really confined quarters. Or, for example, if there's a big group of people. Wow, we barely got out of that bomb in time. So we're just going to keep on rotating. That guy seems like a pretty aggressive player himself, but we don't want to deal with him, to be honest. So we're just going to keep on attacking at these people. We'll probably get a kill eventually on one of these players over here. And we're just going to pick up these stars as we go around. Get this speed boost. Not today, Reddit. I think there's someone down here. So in this case, I'm just going to charge up, use two, and we might get a kill here just from a snagging. Not going to kill myself, hopefully. Just from snagging a kill on people. Yeah. What? Was there a bomb? Where was that bomb? I have no idea, to be honest. We'll just leave this game. There's also been some glitches going on where there's invisible bombs or something. I don't really know, to be honest. But I guess we'll go into our third tip, which is essentially our last. Time your bombs. Now, what I mean by that is you want to wait before you hit your bomb at someone. Why? Because as soon as it lands on a guy, it explodes. So it gives him no time to react, and so he cannot escape. And if he can't escape, he's going to die, and you're going to get a kill, and he's one less player you need to deal with later, which is, very good, because less players, the more likely you win. I don't know what I want to do here. Probably just hit those down there. That's probably a kill. What? Wow! That guy got lucky. Wow. Whatever. That was well played. Good job, dude. The two bombs backfired. I had nowhere to go. Again, so that's just, you have to be careful when you're using more than one bomb, because sometimes you might miss one bomb. And then you might panic and then run into the bomb. I've had a lot of experience with the bombs. Yeah, I know. This is my fifth time recording this episode, because all four times have failed, and it's really disappointing because a lot of them, there was one episode I had 3 win streak and they were all like 8 kills. So I was pretty sad that I lost that footage. My stupid phone ran out of storage or something. I don't really know. So we're going to time this bomb. So especially right now, we're just going to wait and then we're going to hit it. So if someone's there, we can get the kill on them. So some 3 stars right here. Now, for example, so we want to wait for the people to come down, then we want to hit it. So they walk right into it, have no time to react. So right here, we're going to wait a little bit and then hit it. We might just get some kills. You'll be surprised. Most of the time, you can just shoot into an empty area and you will be surprised how many kills you pick up, because they're off screen, so it'll be even more surprising when a bomb comes out of nowhere and you're just randomly guessing. So we're just going to keep on attacking over here with our bombs, timing them so they go far enough and then they also explode on unsuspecting people. There is a person up here though. Can we hit him and keep him in our bomb radius? Wow, I think that should have hit him, to be honest, but it's fine. We just have to keep on running and not die. So these people are in a big group over here. Granted, they have speed right now, but they're going to have to come back here eventually. And we have to just keep on running. My phone's starting to lag quite a bit, which is not good. No bueno. But we're just going to keep on moving, keep on swimming. And there's a lot of people left in this sort of thing. So this is, again, where timing our bombs to where they'll eventually just hit someone. Because if we time them enough... Okay, we're just going to charge up our bombs here, our bat here. Because if a guy runs at us, we're just going to get a kill. Like, there's a lot of people over here. There's just so many people. He needs to run out of the way. He kills himself. We're just going to swing our attack because we don't care. We want these stars. And again, we're just going to wait. The bombs go three. We got the kill. Again, timing that perfectly so that guy had no time to react. We're going to just swing it all the way up there. Get out of this bomb's way because a bomb travels three. A bomb travels three without anything, without any force, against it. So we can use that knowledge to our advantage and be able to calculate some attacks. I hate swings. Oh, they're all down there. So we're going to time this perfectly, hopefully. Wow, he hit it back just so we can get it down there. We're going to keep on going, keep on attacking. We're going to keep on just bombarding this guy with bombs because eventually he'll probably get hit by a bomb. As long as we do not choke and we're going to advance to him. How did that not get him? I don't know. We're just going to spam some bombs here. And then we're going to time this bomb to be hopefully exact on the money. No, how did that not hit him? I don't know. This is getting really intense, to be honest. Hit it up there. Three. Can we get him? We got the kill. Let's go. Again, timing our bomb so we can get the kill got us the win in the end. And it was a decent kill. Three kills. And we get the level up. So hopefully this video is safe. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys learned something useful and you guys can up your own KD and your own level and win rate. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys subscribe, like, leave a comment what you guys want to see next. Besides that, King Blake out.